Let's go.
Hey guys, what's going on? This is the Ninja Reviewer here, and I know this review is pretty much late, but I decided to get out of the way anyway, so this is My Little Pony Friendship is Magic, Season 6, Episode 5. Gauntlet of Fire. Yeah, definitely not a reference to Harry Potter right there. So, if you catch my drift, because, you know, yeah. So, when it comes to this episode, especially now, a lot of people were fearing because this is a Spike episode. A lot of people were going apeshit because is this a Spike episode? You know how normally how Spike episodes go. But I have to say, out of all the Spike episodes I have seen in the past, this was my favorite Spike episode they have ever done. They did it. They actually made a fucking good Spike episode. And even a great one. They actually did it. They finally made a great Spike. We haven't seen an episode like that in a long time since the Equestria Games. And we haven't seen one ever since like the Season 4 stuff. Like those two back-to-back Spike episodes that we had. And I think those were the last step of the ladder when it comes to Spike episodes. But this episode right here definitely destroys them both. Because I loved this episode to death. Now, when it comes to that, it's because... Now, a lot of people did say, you know, the writing did feel like a little bit flat. But to me, it didn't bother me much. Because this was actually more an adventure-type feel of episode. And we haven't had an episode like this in a long time. And I really loved it. When it comes to this adventurous feel, the world-building with the dragon lore, it was really awesome. Just seeing the designs of the dragons looked really cool. Which were nice. I liked the designs of them. Even though they were a bit shorter compared to the... massively big dragons we saw back in like the past older seasons. But with that being said, though, I still enjoyed the living hell out of this episode a lot. Yeah, you know, some of the dialogue might be a little bit corny here and there, but you know what, I'll take it for what it is, because you know I'm used to it when it comes to the show by now, and definitely it's my favorite. So let's just start off with Rarity and Spike. They're just pretty much searching, you know, for like some gems in some cave. Then all of a sudden we see Spike, and he's glowing, like really, really glowing a lot, like completely light. And it basically is some kind of sign to actually been summoned by the Dragon Lord himself. So basically, that's what Celestia and Luna were pretty much told Spike and Twilight and Rarity that was the case, because that was the only rare thing that they actually know. They don't know everything in full detail because, you know, they're not dragons themselves, but when it comes to ponies and dragons, they have a bit of a view between each other because, you know, let's be honest, not all of them are pretty much more friendly with ponies, so, you know, they are pretty much on the side. But when it comes to this episode, though, I do have a feeling we might get some kind of alliance between the dragons and the ponies. That would be really cool. So anyways, get into that. We get into the dragon lore stuff, and the boss himself looks fucking cool. This fucking thing is huge, man. Fucking huge as shit. This dude is like the hugest fucking dragon you'll ever see. When I saw the little snippet preview, I was fucking stoked, man. I was fucking hyped. Like, yes, is what I'm talking about. This is what I'm talking about right here. That dragon, man, the big ass fucking dragon, the dragon lord, dude, straight up. He looks like something from like Skyrim or something like that, like with the little helmet and shit. But also, it did give me a little bit of a Game of Thrones vibe, even though I don't really watch too much of Game of Thrones, but I did kind of, you know, feel that vibe. You know, some of the old, ancient, you know, 17th century time, you know, knights and dragons kind of thing, which was really cool. A very nice touch I really liked. And then we get introduced to his daughter named Amber, who wanted to compete to actually get to his actual staff. And it goes into this, like, lava cave, which I forget the name of it. Just put the comment section down below. My memory's still a little bit fuzzy because I saw it down when I was in Jamaica before the wedding started. So what happened was that pretty much we see that, and then it falls to this fucking volcano. Very nicely done, drawn. Like, I gotta say, the animation for this episode, for the world building, for the dragon lore, fabulous job. It looks wow. Like, it looks really well done. Yeah, even though most of the mountain areas, you know, are kind of like rocks, but the inside of the cave was what really blew my mind away. So anyways, we see that Amber could compete, but it's like, no, only the big, strong type of dragons can compete, and you wimpy little dragons can't do it. And it's like, well, I will admit, we've seen this kind of stuff here and there before, especially the lesson, which I will admit, yeah. Excuse me. I will admit, when it comes to the lesson, though, it is, you know, been there, done that before. Someone, a hero doesn't always have to be someone so big and tough. Now, a hero could be anybody, no matter how big or how small or how weak. You know, anybody can be a true ruler. Anybody can be a ruler of something. So the lesson there, you know, I might have been there, done that. But it was a really cool, strong lesson, though, which I didn't mind it, even though we've seen it go. But I'm going to let that aside. What was the best part of this episode was Spike. Spike was the MVP of this episode. He got so much development when it comes to him actually helping out someone as a friend, something without him even screwing up, which is actually really cool. He was very helpful with this episode, especially when he was helping Amber through, like, the competition and stuff. Oh, yeah, we get that red dragon. Where the fuck his name is? I forget. I just call him Nelson Muntz, because obviously he's just, you know, the guy just goes like, ha-ha, and he has, like, this, like, sarcastic little joke attitudes. You know, he's a bully, you know, typical dragon bully. I mean, I guess it was alright seeing him again. It was kind of cool. You know, hey, giving a little throwback, seeing some of the old characters again. Which, you know, again, something I like, throwback of seeing older characters. So that was pretty cool. I think his name is Garble. Yeah, Garble, I think his name was. I think it was Garble. I don't remember the exact name, but whatever, though. So, anyways, while they're there, it turns out that Amber, even though, you know, she's not really into this whole feelings of friendship, she's not into the whole feelings of helping others, she's more of a solo kind of character. However, though, when it comes to Spike and the way that he was actually treated and the way that she's been helping him out, etc., she's like, you know what, we have something in common, why don't we just try to help each other out? But then once it got to the cave, she was trying to say, like, all right, that's it, you got me this far, it is a competition after all, so, you know, we gotta be in it to win it. So basically what happens is, like, and I really do like the whole Twilight and Rarity just being, like, the whole little cheerleader from side to side. I really miss, well, we did see some Easter eggs, by the way, if you actually saw some of those Easter eggs, Crackle. Motherfucking Crackle was in it. Even though it's not the actual costume thing, it was a little nice Easter egg that the writers actually threw in with the Crackle, which was kind of funny. A little funny reference from the season 2 episode, which I thought that was actually pretty funny, with from Dragon's Quest. That was actually really funny. Even though I really missed that actual disguise that they did have, though, which I'll admit I do miss that one. But regardless, though, the whole rock thing was actually kind of funny. And seaweed ponies. Because, you know, seaweed ponies. Hey, it's not sea ponies, but it's close enough. So then we also get, Spike finally, you know, just says to Amber, like, you know what? You know what? You know, you really, you know, even though you don't really appreciate friendship, I think, you know, you're starting to get the gist of it. But even though not really. So, you know, after all that happens, apparently we see that the staff is finally there. Spike and them finally reach it. Then all of a sudden, Garble's there. He actually makes it there at the same time. He's about to fight Spike off. Then we get a pretty cool action scene of Amber versus Garble. And that fight was actually pretty cool, just seeing the struggle. Then while that happened, Spike finally got the actual staff. He became somewhat the ruler. But then, you know, he actually told Garble, yo, when you go see your dragon friends, you gotta give them a hug. And it's like, why? It's like, just do it, you know? I don't have to explain shit. So it's like, alright. So then he kind of actually listened, because now he is pretty, you know, the ruler. Yeah, I know a lot of people cringe to that part about him with, you know, this so-called punishment when it comes to hugging and all that stuff. But, yeah, I will admit that was a bad part on Spike. Like, really? Really, dude? That's the kind of punishment you would give him? The punishment I would give him is just completely change his look or his 1-8 and make him change completely. Like, you know what? Why don't you just stop being an asshole and just start actually becoming more nicer? But, you know, whatever. I guess that works too. So anyways, you know, Spike and Amber get this little hug, even though she's not used to it, but it's okay. It's whatever. And I did like that one line, though, where she's like, please don't make me talk about my feelings. I kind of get that way, too, when it comes to certain lovey-dovey stuff like that. So then at the very end, though, we do get to see, you know, Amber is the new ruler. So she's, Spike says she's more fitting for it anyway, because his home is in Ponyville and blah, blah, blah. We pretty much get the gist of that. So at the very end of the episode, we see Amber become the new ruler. Her dad was pretty much pissed off because of the fact that she kind of disbanded her from being in the competition in the first place. But then, you know, of course, like I mentioned, a lesson. A hero doesn't have to be big or small or weak or strong, whatever. A hero could just be anyone, an honorable ruler, someone that can actually be a true ruler or something. And you know what? That was a lesson that we've been there, done that. But you know what? It's a good lesson, so I'll let it pass regardless, though. But overall, when it comes to a Spike episode and making the dragons evolve themselves and becoming more well-developed as a race, that was a pretty good shit on Spike's part. That was really well done. And Spike really wasn't annoying in this episode. He actually was very helpful. He actually gave some character development, not only for him, but for Amber, and a possibility of a reuniting with each other when it comes to a reunion, not to mention a little ally forces when it comes to dragons and ponies. Now that will be awesome. So overall, when it comes to this episode, I really loved it. It was definitely one of my favorite episodes of season 6. So far, I finally got a 5 out of 5 rating. This was such an awesome episode. Just seeing Spike get well developed, seeing the dragon races was actually really cool. The new environments, everything about it. The comedy was also pretty funny. Even though some jokes were a little bit, some of them were okay. Some of them were just puntastic. But other than that, that's pretty much it though. So I would give it a 5 out of 5. Definitely one of my favorite episodes of season 6 so far. I know a lot of people may not agree with me, but that's definitely so far one of my most favorite episodes of that time. So let me know your thoughts in the comment section below of MLP Gauntlet of Fire, season 6, episode 5. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I'll see you guys later on this Saturday for episode 6, which I forget the title of the episode. Come on, think about it. I don't even remember the title of it now. I think it was supposed to be a Twilight episode. I don't remember. But regardless, I'll just see you guys for the next episode. So, until then, this is the Ninja Reviewer signing out. Peace, soul, love, chicken grease, and the sky's the limit. MM Manga fans, keep supporting what you read and what you watch. And bronies, bro who brony on. I'll see you guys this Saturday for episode 6. Bye-bye.